Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going to be showcasing financial secret number two, and that is that fees can cost you much more than you think. So today I'm going to showcase you exactly what fees actually cost you when you go to put money into the marketplace or use an advisor. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so right now so you don't miss any future updates like this one, and then I can keep bringing you other financial secrets and tips. So investment fees are something that no one likes to pay, but if you want to put money in the market to get better growth, it's just something you're going to have to accept. There's no way around it. But what we can do is try to minimize the fees that we do have to pay to a degree. So it's important to know that when you have money in the marketplace, there are different layers of fees. If you use a financial advisor to help you run things and manage your investments and help you with your financial plan and all of that stuff, you're going to have to pay them a fee. But on top of that, every single fund that you have within your portfolios also have their own fees with it. And depending on the institution you choose, they can also tack on their own fees. So typically there's at least three layers of fees for most people. All right, so on my screen is just a really simple Excel spreadsheet that we use to calculate fees just to kind of raise awareness to what things actually cost. So if we have someone that had $500,000 and they're gonna be earning 5% over the course of their lifetime, and they have a fee of 1%, and we're gonna look at over a 15-year time period. So this first column called gross is assuming no fees. If you lived in a perfect world where you could put money somewhere, grow at 5% and not pay a dime in fees, this is how it would look. You would have $500,000 going in year one. At the end of 15 years, you'd have a little over $1 million and you would have earned $539,000 in interest alone. But we all know we can't do that, so we're gonna have to pay fees. So if we assume just a 1% fee, which is what most financial advisors charge their clients, that 1% fee in year one is $5,200. So remember, that's 1% of the total account value here. Now you pay that every year. Now as the account goes up, and this is where a lot of people don't realize, is as your account grows over time, the fees rise with it. That's one of the cons with investing and paying fees on a percentage basis. So you can see when the guy finally has $1 million, he's paying a little over $9,000 in fees. And in total, you would have paid $104,000 in fees, and then you'd only end up with $894,000. So you can see fees can take a really big toll on your account value over time. So that's why it's important. If you're going to be paying an advisor to help you manage things, you're not overpaying them. Now, the 1% I'm showing here is the average fee that people charge, but it's definitely possible to be charged a higher fee. In fact, I see it every day. Many people that use large institutions actually pay higher fees, because all those brick and mortar locations with thousands of employees, and you walk into their office and they have, you know, nice furniture and all the refreshments in the office, guess who pays for that? That's you guys paying the higher fees for those big establishments. So it's important to take note of that and go ahead and double check what you're actually paying those financial institutions. Now, if you have a right financial advisor, they're worth every penny of these fees here, and it saves you all the stress of managing investments, dealing with market fluctuations and taxes and all the rule changes and things of that nature. Now back to the calculator. So you see we paid $104,000 in fees, but there's one thing I want to point out. If you added the $104,000 in fees back to the $894,000, you still end up with less than that $1 million we had in the left-hand column here. But why is that? Well, that's what we call an opportunity cost. So anytime we're paying fees to anything, whether it's to a financial advisor or for a fund, or we're going out to dinner and paying for that, they all have opportunity costs associated with them. And what that is anytime we spend money on something, we lose ability for that money to earn us more interest in the future. So once that money is gone and out of our pockets, it's no longer working for us, earning us more money. So opportunity cost is a silent fee within these accounts. So not only do you have to pay fees every year for the account management, but once that fee has left your account, it's no longer working for you and earning you money. Now, like I said earlier, 1% is the industry standard for what financial advisors charge, but there are many out there that charge higher, 1.5, even 2% in some cases. But that's not the only fees you're paying. Anytime you're using some kind of fund company, they're going to charge you a fee to use their fund. So you have to pay those fees as well. And depending on the institution you actually have the account with, oftentimes they have their own fees on top of that. So more often than not, you're not going to be paying 1% all in. You may be paying 1% for advisor, but when you add up the other costs, sometimes they're add up to 1.5%, which is most commonly what I see out there. I can see your fee went up from there. But the majority of people I actually do account reviews with are paying fees north of 2% without even noting it. In fact, when we ask them what their fees are, they tell me it's 1%, but after diving into it, it ends up being 2% or higher. So most people are paying way more in fees than they even realize. Now, the whole reason I made this video is just to bring awareness to what fees can cost you in the long run. And you want to make sure you're working with an advisor that's worth the fee that you're paying and has your best interest in mind, and is not just using funds that charge more than they necessarily need to do. And if you really want to keep your fees to an absolute minimum and actually pay no fees at all, there's a platform that can do that for you. So you pay no fees at all, you get some of the stock market growth when it goes up, and you get none of the losses when it goes down. So check out Financial Secret number 3, and that is how to protect and grow your retirement without taking any risk.